I bang my head against the walls of Babylon, wondering if these walls will ever fall. The wind rages like the bastard children of Africa who ring dance around the bodies of black angels lynched by their own halos. Do I retaliate against the face of hate or the haste of fate? Do I let justice run its course or scream at the walls until my voice gets hoarse? Within the belly of the beast, people shriek and gnash their teeth. Rumbles crescendo into riots. People die to live in quiet. Black lives matter. All lives matter. Peace.
Oh, freedom. Oh, freedom. Black lives matter. Yes, they do. We got our hands up. Please don't shoot. We want justice in our land. We are free.
Galvanize, to cause people to become so excited or concerned about an idea or an issue that they want to do something about it. To shock or excite people, typically into taking action. We started Galvanize almost 10 years ago in the summer of 2005 as a network for artists of color to come together to support one another, to collaborate, to share ideas, to uplift one another, thereby uplifting the community, because we matter. Black lives matter. Michael Brown matters. My brothers matter. My nephews matter. I matter. Black lives matter.
I am an artist, but first I am a mother of a young black boy. So for those of you who are fighting the good fight, thank you. You are appreciated. Don't give up. Black lives matter.
Black lives matter. I'm still trying to wrap my mind around the fact of us saying black lives matter. Why do we have to? It should be obvious. But once every black life matters to us, then black lives matter.
Black lives matter.
Ignorance, allied with power, is the most ferocious enemy justice can have. James Baldwin. Black lives matter.
This is a cold world. Do you know what you're fighting for? This is a cold. This is a cold world. Do you know what you're fighting for?
America needs a lobotomy, a lobotomy, lobotomize that deep-seated, conditioned core of hate, of suspicion, of fear, just at brown skin. Black lives matter.
We hold these truths to be self-evident,
that all men are created equal,
that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights,
that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness,
that among these are life,
that among these are life,
that among these are life,
that among these are life. Black lives matter.
For all those who don't already know this, black lives matter.
Don't forget about the silence. It too believes that black lives matter.
Face the difficulties of today and tomorrow. I still have a dream. Is it a dream? Deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women are created equal. I have a dream that my four children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. And if America is to become a great nation, this must become true. This must become true. This must become true.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, that to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed, that whenever any form of government becomes destructive of these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or to abolish it, and to institute new government, laying its foundation on such principle and organizing its powers in such form as to them shall seem most likely to affect their safety and happiness.
Black Lives Matter.
August 9th, 2014, 12:01 to 12:03 p.m. Fact, Mike Brown and a friend were walking home from the convenience store when they were approached by a police officer. Fact, an altercation happened between Mike Brown and the police officer. Fact, whether Mike Brown ran away or turned around and faced the officer, 7 to 8 shots were fired into Mike Brown's body. Mike Brown was unarmed. Fact, Mike Brown was unarmed. Fact, Mike Brown was unarmed. 7 to 8 shots. Unarmed. Black body lies dead in the street for 4.5 hours. These are the facts. Black lives do indeed matter.
We, the descendants of the survived, the faithful consumers of the televised, tuned in to see if Lady Justice would screw us over another time, and she did. Her legs pried open, still raw from the wounds of forced entry and unlawful penetration, telling us we are disposable in this nation while pouring libation of unburned 40 acres between mules and miles with no safe harbor, swallowing fallen tears for fallen martyrs, now turned trending topics and conversation starters. Life in America being black, beings being the target and being slaughtered. We, the survived, believe that according to law in this country, all we have left is merely the right to remain silent and nonviolent amidst the slaughter of the slain. God forbid we demand justice, revolt or call their names, or worse still, rebel for change. We have vowed to torch down the system with art, politics, and flames, knowing each day concrete greets the bodies of those who remain. We will risk rusting our wrists with cuffs, battling in cyberspace to prove and protest that Black Lives Matter more than enough.
Black lives matter when we're shopping at other people's stores. Black lives matter when we're singing and dancing. Black lives matter on the basketball court. Black lives matter on the football field until you get carried off the field. Black lives matter when they're in uniform. Black lives matter in private prisons. Black lives matter in boxing rings. Black lives matter when slaves were sold, but don't mean a thing in the wrong end of a white cop's gun or a chokehold, because then black lives don't matter. Forensic pathologist expert testimony don't matter. Unconstitutional statutes fed to a hand-picked grand jury don't matter. A community of witnesses don't matter. Being unarmed don't matter. Videotape murder don't matter. A black attorney general don't matter. A black president don't matter. No justice, no indictment, no remorse, no revenge in a system that pretends that black lives matter.
The evening that Darren Wilson was not indicted for killing Michael Brown, I didn't sleep well that night. I finally fell asleep. I woke up about 3 o'clock in the morning, and I had dreamt. I dreamt a lot. I was walking down a street at night, and there were three young black men. And as I started to approach them, I got scared. And faked like I forgot something, and started to go back in the direction I was coming from, and went into a restaurant. The three young men were really upset with me for being scared of them for no reason. And they followed me into the restaurant to confront me. And I denied it. Denied. That was what I was doing, but it was what I was doing. I was trying to escape them without any provocation. Later on in the dream, I'm in a house with these same three young black men and other black people, and we're all in the same house together. And I'm going through the rooms to the last room that will lead outside, and it's night. And I realize that there is an organized force outside of the house with guns and flashlights, and that they're going to come in and they're going to kill us. And I don't have enough time to warn anybody, and I don't have enough time to get out. So I decide to hide. And so the dream keeps jump cutting. They break in, and I just don't make it to my hiding spot. And then it starts again, and they break in, and I just don't make it to this different hiding spot. And it keeps happening a few times, till finally the dream allows me to get inside of a closet and hide under these coats, and there are boots, and I have a knife. And it's so dark in the closet, I can't see anything, but I know that there are dead rats on the floor of the closet with me. And I listen, and I hear this organized force come in, break in, and kill everybody. And I can't stop it, and I can't save anybody, so I stay silent. And then they hear, and I hear the police coming. And I wait in silence while they leave, and I listen as the police come in and find everybody and the old-timey sound of pictures being taken and the flashbulb popping. I listen to that happening, and I know they're investigating the crime scene. And finally, after I feel completely safe, I say very quietly, I'm in the closet. I'm a victim. I'm not one of the bad guys. I've been hiding. I explain it. I'm in here. And I walk out. They let me walk out. And they kill me. That was how I processed on the first night that the indictment didn't happen. Black Lives Matter. When the nightmares stop.